Devo number 5, who's washing your brain and where did you get your worldview?
Where is God when life sucks?
If you choose the wrong pair of glasses, you may find yourself in a worse plight than a blind man, thinking that you're seeing clearly when in reality, your vision is severely distorted.
Welcome to Where is God When Life Sucks? A daily devotional jumpstart to your day with scripture, insights from the Bible, along with illustrations from today's pop culture, guaranteed to strengthen your faith and help you focus in on the most important thing in life, knowing God's love, acceptance, and forgiveness. And now, here's Brother Dale with today's Devo.
Just a reminder, if you like this podcast, would you hit the subscribe button and share it with your friends? Thanks. In Colossians chapter 2, verse 6, Paul writes and says, "And now, just as you accepted Christ Jesus as your Lord, you must continue to follow him. Let your roots go down deep into him, and let your lives be built on him. And then your faith will grow strong in the truth as you are taught, and you'll overflow with thankfulness. Don't let anyone capture you with empty philosophies and high-sounding nonsense that comes from human thinking and from the spiritual powers of this world rather than from Christ." Well, this is a continuation of some of my thoughts that I shared in Devo number 3. So if you haven't heard it, make sure you listen to Devo number 3. Chances are you've either seen Disney's animated film The Lion King or you're at least familiar with it. This 1993 animated classic, it gave us the song The Circle of Life. It's the circle of life. And it moves us all through despair and hope, through faith and love, till we find our place on the path unwinding in the circle of life. Well, if you saw the film, I suspect you can still sing this song. Like everything we read, watch, or listen to, The Lion King contains a worldview. So what is the worldview in The Lion King? Well, it certainly isn't the worldview from the Bible. The notion of the circle of life is that history is circular, and that the present is heavily influenced by the spirits of your ancestors. This idea is closer to Eastern pantheism or native spiritualism than the linear view of history as presented in the Bible. My wife and I, we watch a popular reality series on cable which follows the homesteading family, the Kilchers, in Alaska. They're an awesome extended family. They're loving to one another as well as to their neighbors. I mean, if you need a helping hand, the Kilchers are there to serve. They really do display so many Christian virtues in their daily lives. But sadly, whenever they kill a deer or some other animal for food, they talk about the circle of life. This pretty much sums up their worldview. When they give thanks, God never enters their thoughts or conversation. They give thanks to the animals and to nature, but not to Almighty God, the creator of all things. Jeff Baldwin at the Texas-based Worldview Academy says, "Worldview is like an invisible pair of eyeglasses. Glasses that you put on to help you see reality clearly. Now, if you choose the right pair of glasses, then you can see everything vividly and you can behave in sync with the real world. But if you choose the wrong pair of glasses, you may find yourself in a worse plight than a blind man, thinking that you're seeing clearly when in reality, your vision is severely distorted. To choose the right glasses, you have to first understand and embrace the true worldview." Tracy F. Munsell, formerly with the Center for Arizona Policy, writes, "I've used a series of 7 questions to help them formalize their own worldview, to help them evaluate competing worldviews. These 7 questions are common to many worldview resources and provide an effective tool for adults as well as teenagers, particularly to evaluate the worldview of books, music, and movies. Here are the questions. Is there a God, and what is he like? What is the nature and origin of the universe? What is the nature and origin of man? What happens to man after death? Where does knowledge come from? What is the basis of ethics and morality? And what is the meaning of human history?" Once you're able to answer these questions from the Bible, you'll be able to apply them to everything you watch, read, or hear. It doesn't matter how many questions you ask. What matters is, where are you getting your answers? I mean, if they come from Scripture, from the Bible, then the odds are that you will have a biblical or Christian worldview. Now, that's something for you to think about as you go through your day. Your worldview will determine how you respond to everything that comes your way today. Here's our prayer. Dear Lord, as Scripture for today says, I'm thankful that you accept me and love me. Cause the roots of my faith and my belief system to go down deep into you. Let my worldview be established in what you say, and not what the world says or believes. And keep me from being captured by the empty philosophies and ideologies that permeate my world. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Well, I've listed some Christian websites that can help you in establishing a biblical or Christian worldview. They're listed on the Where is God When Life Sucks podcast website, which can be found by going to dalesdevos.weebly.com. That's dalesdevos, dalesdevos.weebly.com. And there you can find transcripts for today's devotional, as well as the podcast page for the program located at podbean.com. So check them out. If you like Where is God When Life Sucks, give me 5 stars on iTunes. Hit the subscribe button now wherever you're listening to this podcast. Check out Where is God When Life Sucks, our podcast page at podbean.com and our website link. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Click on share and let your friends know about this podcast. You've been listening to Where is God When Life Sucks, Devo number 5. New Devos drop daily. Join me tomorrow for a new Devo. Until then, shalom.